Okay, so I like to sit around the fireplace and read my books, or just relax, read the Bible, listen to Miles Monroe, my mentor, and listen to his messages because he did pass away. And so I am creating a space in there to do that, and that's coming along nicely. At the same time, I'm decorating for harvest for the fall. I'm also reorganizing my and purging through my Christmas decor and setting that up in the sunroom so that I can start decorating early after I finish my decor for the fall. I'm going to start slowly implementing my Christmas decor. And I'm also working in my dining room. We recently brought a new piece of furniture. It's a well-needed piece of furniture. It's a bar. And although we don't drink, I'm into smoothies and I experiment with other drinks because, like I said, I can't have a lot of sugar in my diet, and so it's important for me to have something tasty. So I'll be experimenting with that. But the main reason for the bar is I needed extra space for glassware, so that it's perfect for that. And I'm working on my home entertainment items, which I have a built-in cabinet that I have to organize in it. That's something I have not done. My china closet needs to be reorganized. The kitchen needs to be reorganized. This kitchen is very small. It's so much smaller than the kitchen in our old home. And if you followed me, you will know why we moved and why we moved on a dime. This kitchen has to be redone as well. I am using, this is a small counter. This counter has to be used for a lot more than just the coffee maker and this area over here where I have some canisters. I usually keep my oils and things here and I have to replenish them, so that's why that's not here right now. But I'm going to redo that because I need to make sure that I have the efficiency that I need since the house is so much smaller than our older home. My cabinets, this is my baking cabinet. I do have a lot of baking items. I have a lot of utensils. I have a lot of kitchen gadgets. I have a lot of things that I've accumulated for the 38 years that I've been a homemaker. And so I've been a stay-at-home mom for 31 years. It's been 31 years since I carried a full-time job outside of my home. Downstairs I'm working because I have our pantry downstairs. Outside of this kitchen is a regular closet that I have used as a pantry closet. So that's where we keep, you know, basic foods, but where we store our food is downstairs, and it's a boiler room that is large enough to use also as a pantry, so it serves two purposes. So you'll also see me working in there. I have to organize that space. My bedroom has to be reorganized because the bedroom is, I would say, half the size of my previous bedroom, and I had a very large bathroom, separate vanity area from bathroom, shower area. I had a walk-in closet. I had an office with a couch in there and the bedroom space with two very large closets, his and her closets. So I lost a lot of space. The bathroom I have here is tiny. The closet, even though we have the his and her closet, it's smaller. And the room does not, I don't have as many options as far as my bed. I have a king size bed, but it has to stay exactly where it is. So I have to work around those things. Our entryway, I would say, is the area that I'm not very fussy about because the way that I designed it, that I decorated it, is the way it's going to stay. Okay, I may change furniture, but I am pleased with the way that it is. My office, right now my office is a storage room because I've been working in the garage, and it was a year before I was able to touch the items that we moved in with, that we could move in until I went through everything. And plus it was too cold. We go through the winter and it's too cold to work in the garage. So I've been separating my Christmas items, putting all of my Christmas items into the sunroom, and I've been going through them there. And I've been putting my craft items into my office because my office is my studio, and that's where I will sew and I do my YouTube videos in there. I will be, once I get it organized, I'll be doing my crafts in there. And my office work, I'm the administrator of our company, and I'm a lot more than that, but you know, I do more of the administration. And so, and I do the taxes, you know, I work with the accountants and whatnot. So I have a lot of work to do there. And my children's rooms, I need to help them out there also. I didn't mention the family room in the basement, so that I'm also working on. So in between those areas, I also have my small laundry closet to work on, my linen closet that I'm working on. I'm putting my linen in the garage, so I need to use the linen closet for my entertainment items. There's another piece of furniture I'm going to need to purchase for my kitchen so that I can have more space for dishware. So as you can see, there's a lot to do. So I'm starting my day with my morning tea so that I can start some of these projects. And I'm going to be working in the garage. So today I'm going to be working on a video. I'm going to be showing you how I'm prepping for putting my clothing overage in the garage, how I'm working on doing that so that I can keep away dust. I'm constantly cleaning the area and sweeping the area because it's a garage, to try and keep it cleaner. I won't have time this year, this fall, to carpet the area that I'm using, so I kind of put some mats down. So it's a mega shift area right now. So it's not a beautiful space, it's storage. But I'm going to work on it so that I can do my very best to accomplish a space that I can feel good about walking in and maneuvering in. And there's also an area in there where I can do my crafts because there's a bench. And none of the cabinetry or anything that's in there is beautiful, but it's functional. I'm going to work with efficiency and functionality. That is my goal. So my theme for all of the projects that I have going on in my home is to...